prensa media. Nais kong ipagtapak na matagal na panahon ako na hindi ko nakakaharap ang media. Although nung ako ay nasa pamahalaan halos araw-araw, ay mga kaharap ko ay mga kaibigan ko sa ating third testing, ating media. Anyway, babasahin ko po sa inyo ang official statement ng National Council of Churches in the Philippines. Pagkatapos ito, aking maikling sasalaysay ang aking pakikipag-usap ngayong umaga. Matagal kaming nag-usap ng Deputy Chief of Staff for Intelligence, Deputy the Major General Ruben Basyao. Kausap po siyang personal. Yung ating minimension dito na nag-apusa sa NCCP as a Communist Front, personal ko pong kinausap ngayong umaga. Isasalaysay ko sa inyo kung ano ang kanyang sinabi sa akin. I can be quoted for that. In the meantime, please permit me to read the official statement of the National Council of Churches in the Philippines, titled NCCP, Standing Up for Loving God and Serving Our People. The National Council of Churches in the Philippines, sadly decries the baseless and unfounded inclusion of its name in the list of, quote, front organizations of local communist terrorist groups, CPG, unquote, by the Department of National Defense, period. The NCCP was one among a number of humanitarian and service-oriented organizations in the list that was presented by Major General Ruben Basyao, Armed Forces of the Philippines Deputy Chief of Staff for Intelligence, during the House Committee meeting on November 5. Sadly, such baseless accusation from the DND is an affront to the work and ministry of the NCCP, its member churches, associate members. By the way, there are 10 member churches and 9 associate members of the NCCP. And local and international partners, not to mention that it is exceedingly alarming and dangerous. We thus respectfully call on the government to seriously review and revisit the unfounded accusations and engage in peace building instead, starting with the resumption of peace negotiations with the National Democratic Front of the Philippines. The NCCP is an ecumenical fellowship of Protestant and non-Roman Catholic churches united in faith in Jesus Christ and faithful in the mission of accompanying the Filipino people towards the biblical vision of a life in all its fullness. John 10, verse 10. Since its founding in 1963, the NCCP has been grounded in Christ's mission, providing the churches with opportunities for common witness and responding together to the needs and concerns of the people. It is committed to unity and reconciliation and in the promotion and protection of human rights. It works with churches and communities, impartial of their religion or beliefs, in order to deliver dignified humanitarian aid and other social services to the people especially to the list of his sisters and brothers. The NCCP stands firmly on its mandate to serve the people and remains faithful to the call of Christ to be with the communities with whom it works and serves. Such red tagging of the state against the NCCP may delay or even prevent the delivery of much needed services to marginalized communities, excuse me, especially in the midst of disasters. Organizations like the NCCP should be more encouraged and supported, especially in a context where human rights. May we have a glass of water, please? Rights are attacked, and fear and insecurity constantly loom. Jesus Christ declared, and quote, "I have said this to you, so that in me you may have peace. In the world you face persecution, but take courage." Thank you very much. "I have overcome the world," unquote, John 16, verse 30. Therefore, the Council encourages its member churches and its national and international partners to remain vigilant and join in this critical juncture with continued prayer and action, standing by the truth, speaking this truth with power, and lifting united voices without fear. November 6, 2019, signed as Sister Ulbi Victorino, retired chairperson, Bishop Rodolfo A1, vice chairperson, Reverend Sharon Rose Joy, who is Durandes vice chairperson, MS Lisa Bell R. Brown, vice chairperson, MS Minnie Ann Matak Kalut, acting general secretary, Mr. Reynaldo M. Natividad, corporate secretary. End of the statement.